Hello everyone. Today we are going to learn story Hans Brinker or the Silver Skates. The story was written by Mary Elizabeth Mapes Dodge. She has lived during January 26, 1831 to August 21, 1905. She was known as an American children's author and editor. She was also best known for her novel, Hans Brinker. The novel takes place in the Netherlands and is a colorful fictional portrait of early 19th century Dutch life, as well as a tale of youthful honor. Hans Brinker, age 15, and his sister Gretel, age 12, lives in Holland in the mid 1800s. 10 years before this tale unfolds, their father, Ralph Brinker, suffered an injury that left him senseless and incapacitated. The children and their mother have lived in poverty ever since. They know Ralph Brinker buried a large sum of money prior to his fall, but he is unable to tell them where it is hidden. Ralph also left a fine watch with Dame Brinker just before his accident, making her promise to keep it safe. She knows nothing of its mysterious origins and has often considered selling it to feed the family. Hollanders get around in the winter by skating on the frozen canals. Hans and Gretel can't afford real skates, so they strap blocks of wood to their feet. Though many wealthy children look down to the Brinkers, a few, including Hilda van Glenk, Peter van Holp, and Annie Bowman, show great kindness and generosity. Hilda and Peter buy Hans homemade necklace so he and Gretel can afford real skates without feeling they have taken charity. These children provide other necessities for the Brinkers as well. The children of the city are overcome with excitement when they learn of an upcoming skating contest. The fastest girl and the fastest boy will each win a pair of silver skates. As Hans goes to town to purchase his skates, he spies the renowned surgeon Dr. Bokman on the street. Hans offers his skate money to the man if the doctor will examine his father, Ralph Brinker. Touched by Hans' story, the doctor refuses the money and promises to come and see Ralph when he returns from a trip. Shortly thereafter, Ralph health deteriorates. Hans and Peter go in search of the doctor, but without success. When Dr. Bokman finally returns, he performs a risky surgery to relieve pressure on Ralph's brain. Ralph Brinker experiences healing that is miraculous. Though his memory is foggy, he is essentially the same person he was before his accident. He helps the family find the lost money, and the Brinkers are finally able to support themselves in a reasonable manner. Ralph also begins to remember the story behind the watch he had left with Dame Brinker. It was given to him by a man named Thomas Hicks, who was fleeing the country. Thomas believed he had inadvertently poisoned someone. He asked Ralph to contact his father and give him the watch. Thomas told Ralph to have his father contact him if it was ever safe for him to return to Holland. On one of Dr. Bokman's visits, the Brinkers discovered Thomas Hicks is a doctor's son. Dr. Bokman explains that he had prevented the poison man death, so Thomas was not in any legal trouble. He is thrilled to learn his son may still be alive. And Hans promises to keep the doctor find Thomas. Through another coincidence, they trace Thomas to England. He returns home immediately. Hans and Gretel, along with all of the children of the town, joined the race for the silver skates. Greta wins in the girls category. Hans is one of the finalists in the boys category. When Peter's skate strap breaks right before the final run, Hans graciously gives his strap to his friend. Peter wins the race. Dr. Bokman later returns to the Brinker's house to introduce his son. Thomas will be starting a business in town and offers Ralph a job as his right-hand man. When Dr. Bokman learns of Hans' interest in surgery, he invites the boy to become his apprentice. Hans becomes a successful doctor. Gretel also grows up to enjoy a happy adult life. The story ends happily. Happy ending. Thank you.